I'd like to introduce the guy playing the five string for you all tonight. This is Steve Leonard. He hails from the sweetest place on earth, Hershey, Pennsylvania. I'd like to tell folks, he's the most bitter guy from the sweetest place on earth. But that's mainly just because he doesn't have a microphone there to defend himself, so he's an easy target. We like to pick on him. But we're going to play one of his tunes now. This is a Banjo Steve original composition. This is a tune he named for a little town up in northeastern Pennsylvania where he lived for some time, snowboarding and hanging out and playing his banjo in solitude up there. This is called Hot Bottom.
Take the whole mix down a little bit. You can probably take the whole mix down a little bit.
Still watching the news these days, but it's a crazy world out there, isn't it?
Absolutely.
And you know, it's a very sensitive environment, you know, 2019, and so we usually try to shy away from politics on stage, but we're going to break that rule now. We're going to play a song of a slightly more political nature. I hope we don't ruffle any feathers or, you know, I hope no one's walking out on us after this one, but this is a song we got from Bill Monroe's Bluegrass Boys. The subject matter of this song is the assassination of President McKinley. So I hope we're not crossing a line here. But so we're going to play it for you. This one's called White House Blues.
Thank you.
that we take requests, we just don't plan. But we're also rule breakers by nature, so we can break our own rules, but we'll probably get back around to that one when the capo is in the right position. But right now, we're going to play one we got from Larry Sparks, one of our favorite singers. So I got to ask, is there any Virginia girls in the room tonight? How about from Richmond? Anyone from Richmond? Oh, man. All right, this one goes out to all Virginia girls, and particularly those from Richmond. According to Larry Sparks here, a real bunch of heartbreakers. So, this is called Blue Virginia Blues.
Thank you.
going to do an instrumental tune now. This was composed by the great mandolin player Frank Wakefield. It's called The New Camptown Races. Faces, familiar faces. Well, we have a lot of friendly faces. We have a handful of familiar faces in the crowd tonight, but I'll pose the question this way. How many of you haven't seen us before? How many of you is it your first time seeing us? Oh, wow, yeah, that's what I thought. Most of you, that's great. Well, we're Serene Green Ribbon from Eastern Pennsylvania. We've not been down in this part of West Virginia too much, but we like it down here. It's our first time with the Purple Fiddle. We have a suitcase over there on the counter full of t-shirts and hats and CDs and stickers and magnets. And if you're interested in free stuff, any of you guys like free stuff?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I thought so. We got business cards sitting in that suitcase too. Take as many as you'd like. As I mentioned before, that's Shane McGee and playing the bass for you all today. We're going to play one of his songs now. Play one that's on that CD sitting over there in the suitcase. That's our first studio album, and we're in the process of getting our second album together right now. It's going to be released sometime this coming season. We're going to play one from the first album now. This is one that Shane wrote called Dusty Pictures.
Yes! Thank you!
Song that we got from one of our favorite groups, Danny Paisley and the Southern Grass. This one, by technicality, I think tonight this is actually true. We're going to really mean it when we sing it. So we come from Eastern Pennsylvania. We came down along the, what's that highway, the 70? So the song's called My Home is Across the Blue Ridge Mountains. And I think that's geographically accurate for us.
My home is across the mountains, and I never expect to see you.
to our good friend Philip, who rode the whole 6 hours or so from Eastern Pennsylvania with us today. Philip's sitting over there in our suitcase. That's our tip jar, Philip, everybody. It's Philip the tip jar, in case you didn't hear. That's, once again, Philip the tip jar, that's an introduction, not a command. Philip the tip jar. Yeah, it's a long way from Pennsylvania. Steve did all the driving today, so you'll have to give him an extra round of applause for driving the whole way there. We're gonna do another one at Chamber, man. This is a song about a couple who, in spite of the fact that they're living together, they're not really feeling so close anymore. It's called Far Apart. Bill Monroe fans out there in the audience tonight? Alright, I'll take that. It's better than none. In case you're not familiar with him, Bill Monroe is known as the father of bluegrass music, so if it weren't for him, we probably wouldn't be up here playing what we're playing for you all tonight. And he wrote a song dedicated to his uncle. His uncle was one of his earliest musical influences. He was an old-time fiddler, and he played square dances with him, has first gigs with him, and he lived with him for a time when he was growing up. The uncle's name is Pendleton Vanderbilt. So this song is called Uncle Pen.
Thank you.
y'all like banjos?
Yeah.
I like you.
I like the honest thing.
You like when you play really fast and play on the mics? We're going to do one of those kinds of songs now. This one's called the Shingo Valley Breakdown. Good conversation.
I lost all my patience. Think I'll go see where it's at.
play a tune now that Shane wrote. Now, although you see him playing bass tonight, he's a pretty fine guitar picker himself, and he wrote this tune on the guitar. And although he wrote it on the guitar, I think it really lends itself to the banjo. Well, if you make up your mind on that one, let us know after the set. This is called Militia.
Thank you.
Take a short break after this next one, but please do stop by our little merch display. You can't miss it. It's brightly lit with Christmas lights. If you want to talk to our banjo player at Separate, he'd gladly hook you up with anything we got in that suitcase. I promise he does not bite unless provoked. And it also looks like we have Bill Red standing guard back there, so I bet he knows a thing or two about Serene Green Magic if you were to ask him a question about it. We're going to finish this set off with a song that I wrote not too long ago. This is a proud of this one mostly because it's the first song I ever wrote with a parenthetical title. I like long, rambling parenthetical titles, but the parentheses is really important this one. See, before I added the parenthetical part, it was just called The Thought of You. And that didn't quite tell the whole story. So the full title is I Finally Can't Stand The Thought of You.
Don't break. I got a four-alarm feeling in my heart, and it's been burning since we've been apart.
Song now. This is one he wrote about going back to his old family home in Roseanne, Kentucky, years later after all the family moved out and the house had been abandoned. And he laments the fact that there's no longer a lake burning in the window where he used to live. And if you ever moved away from home and drove back through your old neighborhood, you kind of know that feeling. It's just really weird, even if that house hasn't been abandoned in a long time. Kind of nostalgic thing. This is called On My Way Back to the Old Town.
I'm on my way back to your home.
Michael Johnson standing to my left. All right. Playing the guitar for you. He also met behind the camera. We're gonna have him sing a sad song, pretty low, man. So grab a tissue, pour yourself a drink. We're gonna get the thing about it. Don't pour it yourself. That's not a lie. Go ask a drink, grab a tissue, find a shoulder to cry on. Do whatever you gotta do. This is a real heartbreak. This is a song we got from Larry Sparks called The Face in the Crowd. Some homework for you all, if you're up to it. see how many notes Steve can fit into one tune.
Go,
you all have to count the notes, and whoever guesses closest to the exact number of notes that he plays in this next tune will get a free sticker on us. This is the train for five.
Story. I was
Thank you.
the author of that song and the one that's doing all the talking tonight, playing the mandolin. This is Quentin Fisher, everybody. Thank you, welcome. Right? Song that we're going to play for you. This is one of the 10 original songs that we recorded for our first album. If you haven't gotten a copy yet, come see us after this set. And this is one, if you ask the rest of the band here, we might tell you that this is an autobiographical song that he wrote just entirely about himself. This is his true perspective. But he might tell you this one is really about creating your own reality. And we like to call this one World's Most Interesting Man.
If the past rocks, drink the
Serene sing you a love song, man. This is a very, very special part of the set to me, anyway, because most love songs in bluegrass music end in murder or heartbreak. But this one doesn't. This is a real love song without any unexpected twists. And Shane does a beautiful job singing this one. I gotta confess something, man. You know, Shane and I are a little under the weather. And our voices are starting to grow. But I couldn't think of a better reason to lose your voice than singing for you all for a Shane Gas. I'm gonna try it out anyway. Keep going until we get out. It's called Good Woman's Love.
Thank you.
standard now. This is a song about a desperate little man. Do you have any desperate little men in the audience today? Fingers for you, all right? Move it. No one ever raises their own hands for that, but there's a lot of fingers getting pointed in my ass on the question. This is called genre.
Thank you.
So I asked this question in the first set, but I'll ask it again. I've seen some different cases walk in here. How many of you are seeing us for your first time right now? All right, I like that. How many of you are here at the Purple Fiddle for your first time right now? Cool. Us too, it's our first time down here. We've never been in both season here before. This is our first time down here as band. And we would love if you would keep up with what we're doing. Look us up at SereneGreenBluegrass.com or search Serene Green on Facebook. And we'll be some of our first West Virginian fans, although I understand some of you aren't from around here, but that's okay. We're gonna do the Bowman Marathon now. This is called Kentucky Ramblin'.
Thank you.
us are putting out the second album. You can look up our, we're running a GoFundMe campaign. Just for the next couple days, we're finishing off at the end of February. But you can find links to that from our Facebook or our website. We have all kinds of good offers that you can put over the CD. You can get a merch package, or you can get VIP tickets to our album release, or for a price, you can even come and cook your dinner in your own home. Also known as pizza party. back here sometime soon and see all of you again. I'm going to send one out to the bartenders. I don't know if this is technically a bar, but you're serving beers, so I guess we got bartenders here. This one goes out to everyone serving up the beers and cleaning up after everybody tonight. We're going to play a song that James Taylor wrote for the country singer George Jones. There's so many country songs about people, you know, sitting at the bar, wasting their lives away and drinking their sorrows away. But there aren't too many songs about the folks on the other side of the bar. Except for this one. This is called The Bartender's Blues.
Bartender, I don't like my work, but I don't mind money at all. I see lots of sad faces, lots of bad cases, and folks with their backs to the wall. And the falls around me in a hole.
Well, if you are, back in this one is for you. This is a tune by the only one player. Here's the size one, it's called Rebecca. Blue Ridge Cabernet.